Hi, my name's Kent. I'm the creative specialist on the Google Web Designer team, and I'd like to show how to use masking in Google Web Designer. Masking means showing or hiding parts of an element. For example, photos are rectangular, but we can add a mask to make it circular, and the effect may be easier to see when you're not working with a plain white background to emphasize the element is becoming transparent rather than just being covered up. There is one big limitation to be aware of. Only rectangle clip path masks work in all browsers, and the other mask types I'm going to show have limited support in different browsers. So let's see what we can do with a rectangle mask. Here's the effect I want to create. I want to wipe away some text with a vertical barn doors effect. And this text can be dynamic, which becomes a pretty powerful effect in a custom ad campaign. To recreate this, I'll start with a new blank file and just give it a name. I'll add some images to my library panel. Bring in my background photo and position it with the alignment controls. Then with my text tool, draw a text box and key in my headline. Switch to the selection tool and in the text panel, choose a nice heavy font and make it larger. Then I can use the CSS panel to tighten up the line height so my text really fills the space. Now with this selected, I want to point out the Clip Path Mask tool and note three options, rectangle, oval, and polygon. I'll choose rectangle, which works in all browsers, and draw a shape. Notice when I release the tool, the mask is instantly applied. I've essentially drawn a window through which I can see my masked element. Next, in the Properties panel, I can make the mask tall enough to reveal the whole sentence. Now I'll set a couple keyframes by right-clicking. And with my last keyframe selected, move the mask down to about the center of my text and make its height 0. I usually add some easing, so right-click Linear, change to Ease Out, and play to see the effect. Now let's talk about some advanced masking features, which again, will not be supported in all browsers. First, let's look at those other clip path options. I'll delete this mask, select the Oval Mask tool, and hold down the Shift key to draw a circle. Set a couple keyframes on the mask. On the middle keyframe, in the Properties panel, make sure Width and Height are linked and reduce the size to 0. Now I want to move it, but it's hard to see, so if I hide the mask and use the Selection tool with the Transform control, I see a little dot where my mask is and can use my arrow keys to move it to the center of this O. Now I'll right-click to remove the first keyframe. Turn the mask back on, and in my last keyframe, use the Shift key again to constrain to a circle large enough to reveal everything. And just to make this easier to see, add one more keyframe and play to see the common iris transition. I mentioned hiding a mask. You can hide any mask type in Stage Preview with this icon, and with the clip path selected, you'll see its outline even during animation. One thing to note, when I move the element, the mask comes with it, but when I move the mask, the element stays put. So if you want to animate something moving past a stationary mask, it's a little tricky, and here's how to do it. First, I'll delete the mask, then right-click my element and select Wrap, which nests it inside a div. Now add a mask to the wrapper, and if I double-click into it, I can animate the contents without disturbing the mask. And here we see the effect. The last clip path mask is Polygon, and with it selected, I can change the number of sides. To set this up, I'll delete the text and bring in a different image. Now draw the polygon. Again, I'll make a couple keyframes and use the polygon tool to drag these vertices around. I can't add or subtract sides, but I can change the shape. And with this, I can create some interesting effects. Now I'd like to show two other completely different types of masks. Right-click any element to add an image mask or gradient mask. Let's do gradient mask. With the mask selected, I can control the gradient on the Properties panel. Click on the icon, and I can control the start and end positions as well as their values, and I can also add new stops. The bottom slider controls the direction. I can also click on the middle icon to change to a radial gradient, and again set the start and end positions and values. I can drag down to delete stops, and click the right icon to reset, and I'm back where I started. I can also drag these stops past each other to reverse the gradient. Notice these gradient masks are by default set to the same size and position as the masked element, but you can control this independently, for example, to create an offset radial gradient. I'd like to point out these masks work on all elements: images, divs, groups, components, even video. I have a complex example here. A dynamic swipe gallery with a deeply nested group of text and images. I'll select the gallery component and apply a mask to it. Then preview to see my dynamic data, animation, and interactivity are all working as expected. The last type of mask I want to demonstrate is image mask, which means using a transparent PNG or GIF as your mask. So for example, I'll select my photo, right-click and select Add Image Mask, and we see the result. I want to point out my mask image has transparency in it, so a black and white JPEG won't work. The mask image must contain transparency. I've used black, but that doesn't matter. All colors will be ignored, and only the transparency is being read in this file. One last trick is using an animated GIF for my mask image, and here we see that effect. Well, that does it for masking in Google Web Designer. Thanks for watching.